Michelle, President Biden, who doesn't have any time to visit our border, is jetting off to Scotland first to talk about, I don't know, the G20. Then he's going to talk about climate change. How much more will he destroy in America's energy sector in order to impress his foreign friends? I'll answer that question in just a moment. The whole world is descending on Scotland this weekend for the Global Climate Change Summit. Joe Biden will be there along with his special climate envoy, John Kerry, who's 6'11" tall, who, despite flying private jets everywhere he goes, feels like he can lecture Americans about their carbon footprint. Why? Because he turns off the lights.
I have a solar system for my home. I drive an electric car now, and we're making more conscious decisions about our use of energy. Within a house. I mean, I've become a flagrant light switch, you know, a chaser whenever I walk through a room or a building. I mean, the biggest thing I'm doing in my lifestyle is traveling around the world trying to do diplomacy.
Right. And of course, with his electric plane. Mark Morano is a Climate Depot publisher and author of Green Fraud, who's heading to the climate summit himself. So what do you fear President Biden is going to accomplish at the climate summit?
Well, what he's going to do, there's a reason Russia and China aren't attending this summit. They don't need to. They're laying low. Joe Biden is going to be doing the bidding for Russia and China at this summit. And very simply, you know, Joe Biden's from day one shutting down pipelines, American drilling, going after fracking, the death of 1,000 cuts, destroying American homegrown energy. Well, at the same time, 9 months later, we're now facing Russian oil imports at 11-year high and increasing. We're now dependent. He's begging OPEC to increase oil, and we have Chinese rare earth mining. We're much more dependent on China than we ever could be. And what Joe Biden's going to do is make all of that much, much worse by pledging all kinds of extreme net zero, reducing carbon dioxide many years into the future in order to essentially appease the international community and get some kind of love back from them.
But Mark, people watching right now and saying, I fear losing the oil and gas industry, but we see the droughts and we see the persistent fires and tornadoes are getting more velocity and strengthening each and every year. What do you say to them?
Well, all you have to do is look at the science and the actual data, not the scientific reports or the summaries like the IPCC, but look at the underlying UN climate reports and even the National Climate Assessment. Look at government data. Hurricanes, floods, tornadoes, droughts, wildfires on climate timescales are not either declining or no trend. So when people say, oh, it's worse, they could probably find a 3-year trend on drought in California, but droughts in California, much, much worse in previous centuries, global drought, no trend. So you cannot do that. This is the way that the media tries to portray it as, oh, the weather's much worse. It was actually worse weather when carbon dioxide was lower in the atmosphere 50, 60, 70 years ago. Documented.
So we're going to get 550, if this ever passes, there's $555 billion in incentives and investment and tax credit aimed at bolstering the deployment of renewable energy. Is that going to make America a better place? Is that going to make the world cleaner?
No, it's going to make energy scarcity. It's going to make shortages and skyrocketing energy prices. Solar and wind combined of U.S. energy production are about 4%, with about 80% fossil fuels. Somehow they're going to start, you know, shutting down fossil fuels and mandating renewable or unreliables, weather-dependent unreliables like solar and wind to take over. The problem is, you know, you have the U.N. chief telling Texas they can't be prosperous unless they go renewable by 2060. So this is, you know, these are UN bureaucrats and the president trying to predict 40 years into the future and basically shutting down entire sectors of the American energy.
Right.
And all it's going to mean is American people are going to get hammered economically at the pump, home heating, traveling. It's not going to affect people like John Kerry 1 ounce.
All right. So Mark Morano is going to the Glasgow Green Summit. Mark, can I recommend a food taster? Just to make sure.
We're going to support Greta Thunberg's message that these are meaningless climate summits. She said this is a blah, blah, blah summit. And she's right. Because if you actually care about rising CO2, every UN summit has seen nothing but rising CO2 afterwards. So this is one time climate skeptics can agree with teen activists. But you're right. I might need a food tester.
I would.
I go to these all the time. Sometimes I've been escorted out by armed UN cops.
Coming up next.